So I guess this would be part next in my natural sharpening stone geek out fest. Associate of mine, Justin Domina, was asking me about a stone he had, which turns out to be a really lovely old world Washita. And it's akin to one of my own collection, measured for specific gravity. So you see it has this sandy texture. I've done a ton of lap work to it. It's 2.38. His is lesser, so it's more in the lily white variety, but they're nice. But he's relatively newer to using sharpening stones in general or the natural ones. So I thought I'd pull out a couple tools and some straight razors and have a little fun with some things and share a few points and recommendations for sharpening stones, honestly. Because Justin, you're asking about the Washita and would you use it as a bevel setter to lap, and you wouldn't. You want a coarser stone. You can get carborundum. This is what I kind of wanted to special share is this is made by Baryonyx Co. It's B-Y-X. Baryonyx Co. Knife Company. Baryonyx Knife Company, but they have this. They call this the American Mutt. Now, what is it? It is pretty unique and pretty special and pretty fucking cheap. This is made from waste materials from other sharpening stone processes. It has silicone carbide, aluminum oxide, and trace amounts of diamond. Very coarse stone. Also very porous. So this is a great stone to do initial lapping and bevel work on, especially if you're working on older tool edges that are rusted or pitted. So I actually don't want to use that on that. Let me find something here. Yeah, this is perfect. This is a rusty fucking razor. There's pitting to the edge. You want to use water and or mineral oil. This is my mint example. I have one more. Also, by the way, they sell these. This has been used a little bit on their website. They cost like $8 before shipping. So that's kind of a really affordable entry price for anyone. Took me a long time. I generally love using water on my gnats. Some of the coarser, like carbides or synthetic stones, they really like oil. So I prefer to use a mineral oil, which I have somewhere. But in the meantime, we're just going to use some water. Or I can find my mineral oil, which is always cheap. Now, if I had a rusty tool edge, and I actually kind of do, I found, there it is, this is the one I wanted to use. This little Austrian Continental, it's definitely hornbeam. It's not beech or anything like that. If you've never adjusted a wooden plane, you know you don't have a depth adjuster. There's a couple tricks. You can pound on the top to drive the cutting iron deeper, or if you have a stuck wedge, it's just as simple as and it will release. Just it's really in there. Shit. See? I can't tell you if I was using this, but I've worked on a little bit, but let's give it some more work on this coarse stone because this has the usual pits you'd find. The bevel is pretty fucking nice, so I'm not going to use this rougher stone on the bevel. I'm going to try to jump some things and see what happens and learn a thing or two. There's still a little bit of a pock pit there, but we're just going to let it ride. This is actually good because I did some of this groundwork, and I lied, I will do this. Because I want to work that wire burr edge just a touch. So that's that. Put that aside. This straight razor needs a lot of work. The pitting goes through the beveled edge. I've done some bevel setting still. Ugh. Just to kind of avoid a little cross-contamination of the water. This is a Spyderco sharpened stone base. Very good. This is an Atoma 120. It's nice. We're going to jump to this Washita, which is very similar to Justin. It's just to show the 1-2. Like, you can really sometimes only need two stones. I think a lot of the old-timers, you know, our forefathers might have only had two sharpening stones. It might have been a Washita or an Arc, maybe a Belgian codicil. I think any old tradesman that was just common day probably only had two, maybe three stones. If they had any more, they're probably pretty well to do. So I've used this Washita a little bit. I have not put a ton of evaluation into it against others, and you'll see how it's not really absorbing a lot of water. Now that's probably due to old embedded oil, and maybe I would even put some mineral oil on this. But this has been dressed very fine. Like, I lapped it flat. I probably dressed it to extra fine on a diamond plate. But we're gonna try the 1-2 punch and maybe pull out a tool, and there's still oil on the back of this, so I'm using oil and water, which is used to freak me out. I used to try to keep the cross contamination to a minimum, but it doesn't really matter on some of these stones. It's just whatever you prefer. Now, I have a lot of muscle memory from doing this for years. Yeah, I love these spray bottles. But if you've ever used any spray bottle, you'll know that eventually this mechanism just kicks the can. So I found some on Amazon. I got 10 of them coming for like 10 bucks. So the oil, I see the swarf. This stone will do a little slurry swarf, which is, if you want to get into the finer points of honing and polishing on finer stones, the slurry swarf is where a potential lot of magic can happen in terms of polishing. And I have some mysteries in my collection that are just like, I don't know what they are, but they are fucking awesome. That's about all I can say about that, I guess. Yeah, I mean, I'm not really trying to rock. I should be rocking to find the bevel. This is a very hard stone. It's not quite stroke, but like, it's, and if you wanted to get, you know, a leather stroke, I prefer to load them with, I think it's called green chromium oxide, but it's green polished compound. They come in a couple colors. I have a few other colors, but green's the only one I've ever used. And we'll try to cut something with this. And I'm already seeing a polish. Like, this is already, like, pretty fucking good. It was a really coarse, really, you know, medium high-end old world Washita, which are, Washitas have a lot of range, I guess. I could sand this coarse or lap it coarse, and it would cut coarse. And eventually that face would break into its higher factor, but I also dressed this one to the highest factor I could find, and Washitas can have that range, which is slightly magical. So that's a good edge. Real good edge. You know, subjectively speaking, a little bit. So I don't have a wide board. I could find one, but this is just quick and dirty. We'll go for the face grain. We'll try to go against the grain. This is mahogany, so it's not a big whoop-whoop, we like to say. And I got some mineral oil on the face, which is fine. These Austrians, they made some righteous tools. We have American hornbeam, so I've heard. I've not had a chance to work it. I've seen some American hornbeam tools. No, I haven't. I've seen European hornbeam tools. Now, you should never do this with a metal mallet, but I don't have a good wooden mallet. I need one. That's really nice. How cool is that? Virgin cuts on this old tool. I picked this up in an antique store like the other week or two ago. One, two. Two stones. Done.